よしま、ほんのしま。
Let's rewind a bit and start from the beginning. So we collected our house keys some time back. What's the first thing you think about when you buy a new house? Most people probably think about furniture, renovations, interior design. Me? I think about the tech. Lights, switches, sensors, network cables, servers, and everything smart. I like smart homes, but let's try to keep it objective too. There were several actual problems that I wanted to solve while setting up this new house. The results were great most of the time, but sometimes... Sometimes it took quite a few tries to get it right, and some of it are still ongoing enhancements. Let's start with a quick walkthrough. This is our new 2-bedroom condo. It's a small place, but a cozy size for 2 persons. The original wall switches were set a little low on the walls, probably for accessibility reasons, but for us, it was a little too low for comfort. There was no point in shifting the original switches, after all, I intended to use these. These are Zigbee scene switches. They are all wireless, so you can position them anywhere. The ones I got run on a small watch battery and last probably 2 years or so. Beyond just height position, these wireless switches gave us an opportunity to put them in more intuitive locations. For example, there are no existing switches in the kitchen. You have to walk over to the bathroom entrance to turn on the kitchen lights. That didn't make any sense. The same goes for the living room. You would have to walk over to the master bedroom entrance to turn on the living room lights. Fine in the day, not so much when it's dark. We placed new Zigbee switches at the entrance. In the kitchen, beside the fridge. One on the central dining table in the living room, right where you enter. In the bedrooms, right at the entrance. And in the balcony itself for the balcony light, rather than in the living room. What allowed me to use all these scene switches are smart lights, which I bought many of. The foyer, kitchen, and balcony are powered by Zigbee downlights. The dining table and master bedroom pendant lights are using Zigbee bulbs. The wall switches controlling the bathroom lights and exhaust fans have both been switched out for Zigbee smart wall switches. A Zigbee LED strip lights up this bar counter. And finally, the 3 smart ceiling lights. But these are Wi-Fi based, not Zigbee. I ended up regretting this decision the most, but more on that later. With all these smart lights and these better placed smart scene switches, controlling the lights while moving through the house became much more convenient. Sometimes, it's a nice feeling to get back home at night, and rather than opening the door to a dark house, it's nice if the foyer light would turn on automatically. Once you have a smart light, all you need is the appropriate trigger to turn it on. I installed a motion sensor. Walk past the sensor and the light turns on for 2 minutes. This works great for both when you're leaving the house and need a little bit of light to put on your shoes, and also when you get back home and enter the house. The only problem was the occasional delay. The motion sensor sometimes doesn't get triggered when you open the door, requiring you to actually step into the house before the light comes on. To solve that, I added a second sensor. A door sensor that detects when the door is open or closed. Now both of these sensors trigger the smart light to come on for 2 minutes. One troublesome thing is to take off your shoes and walk all the way back into the house to turn off a bedroom light. In the beginning, I thought, hey, I'll just switch it all off from my phone app. But honestly, that never happens. Once you're out the door and on the elevator down, you tend to forget immediately about whatever lights that were left on. So having another switch at the entrance foyer was perfect. I have it set on a scene group that turns off all the lights in the house. One of the things I wanted when I was setting up the workspace in my room was to put my PC further away so it's not on my desk or directly under it. This would mean less fan noise and less heat near me. The perfect place was this wall shelf. In order to do that, I used extra long cables to connect both USB and DisplayPort to my monitor, which operates as a hub for all my other devices, keyboard, mouse, soundbar, webcam. The problem with this distance was turning on the PC. Instead of squatting down at the shelf to push a power button, I have a smart button under my desk that turns it on. How this works is that this button triggers a wake on LAN automation that turns on the PC over the network. Oh, and also I have quick Siri shortcuts on my phone to set my desk to standing or sitting heights. For our bathrooms, there's only one switch that controls both lights and the exhaust fan. Either you have both on or you have both off. Initially, I considered having smart lights here as well, but that wouldn't have solved the problem. As long as you wanted to turn off the exhaust fan via the wall switch, the lights would definitely go off as well. There was no way to have the lights kept on separately, hence I went with conventional lights instead, and opted for a smart wall switch. Neither of our bathrooms have windows though, which means that we definitely want to leave the exhaust fan on after a shower to dry out the bathrooms. But I also didn't want these running 24/7. What made the most sense was to also have it on a timer. After someone uses the bathroom, the light and the exhaust could stay on for up to 4 hours, then shut off automatically. So I happily installed a motion sensor and set up the automation. The light will come on automatically if someone enters and turns off after 4 hours. At least, that was the plan. But... this happened more than once, and not to me. Hence, many of these angry messages about my not smart home. The short explanation is that having my motion sensor in an obscure corner caused it to fail to detect presence occasionally, and the timer in my smart home did not restart correctly. What I have now is a much better placed motion sensor as well as a door sensor, both triggering the 4-hour timer and restarting it appropriately. This setup hasn't failed yet. That was just the first of many incidents. So I was out of the country for a couple of weeks for work and received this.
Your smart home not smart.
One problem with having all these smart lights is that the original wall switches have to be on perpetually. Otherwise, without power, they would be disconnected and you wouldn't be able to turn them on via smart home controls. But sometimes these switches do get turned off accidentally. And once a smart light has no power, of course the scene switches don't work as well. The current solution is just a cross X sticker on these switches to remind folks not to touch them. But I have also considered swapping these out for smart wall switches as well. That way I can lock them in a perpetual on state. For now though, no one has touched the main wall switches in months, so I hope it stays that way. If you're asking why I chose smart lights and not smart switches, I wanted the ability to also control brightness and color dynamically from the app. For example, the bedroom light is kept in a warmer and dimmer state that is better for going to sleep versus the white light for the workroom. With a smart wall switch and conventional lights, I would only be able to control them to turn on or off. My smart home revolves around Home Assistant. It's an open source smart home automation solution which you can host locally on a private server within your home network, with no reliance on the cloud or any foreign servers. This was one of the main goals I had when I was setting up this new house. Using Zigbee to MQTT, an add-on for Home Assistant, I was able to pair and control all my Zigbee devices without needing to use the original 2-year Smart Life app. This was the ideal state I was looking for that I thought would give me the most stability. But no. Remember the 3 ceiling lights I mentioned earlier? So while most of the Zigbee lights and switches gave me no issues, the 3 ceiling lights are not Zigbee. They are Wi-Fi based and were a lot more complicated to set up. I needed a separate add-on in Home Assistant to manage these lights locally, which required many hops to get working, including getting a 2-year developer account. The complex setups would have been fine if everything just stayed working, But the problem is these lights would occasionally become unavailable and stop responding. The solution would be to reload them in Home Assistant. I found a script that would supposedly do this automatically, but somehow I kept needing to trigger them manually. This was fine if I was at home when it happens, but somehow it always only happens when I'm away. The workaround here is, of course, to switch them out to Zigbee versions. We purchased these recently, but haven't gotten around to setting them up. It's a pain to have to climb all the way up to the ceiling. Back in my old home, when my ISP went down for maintenance, or if the Smart Life servers were down, I couldn't control my lights. Considering that the main reason I wanted to set up Home Assistant was to avoid this very issue, this was the last thing I was expecting to receive complaints about. So yeah, my ISP went down for maintenance on the nights that I was away, and even without internet, both the smart switches and the app would continue to work. But what I forgot to account for was that with the internet down, people would naturally switch back to mobile data on their phones instead. And hence, because she was not on the Wi-Fi home network, she was not able to load the app to turn off the lights while lying on the bed, and had to get up and turn it off from the switch on the wall. So I bought a smart knob to put on the bedside table that can control all the bedroom lights easily. For this one, I really have to say it had nothing to do with my setup or scripts. It was just a simple hardware failure. The 2-year bulb I previously bought was defective, and after a few months of usage, it started triggering itself on for no reason. I actually checked through the locks in Home Assistant to verify this. This was the easiest fix, as I replaced it with a Zigbee bulb from IKEA. Actually, I ended up replacing all the bulbs in my home with Zigbee bulbs from IKEA. They seem to be pretty reliable so far, and are all supported by Home Assistant out of the box. Right, so that's the summary of my whole smart home fiasco. Honestly, so far, I'm loving Home Assistant. It has been pretty fun tinkering with it off and on over the past few months, and figuring out some of the automations and device setups. I was just toying around with this Zigbee IR controller the other day, and had to work with complicated IR codes to control my AC with it. For me, figuring out all of these is part of the fun, but it's definitely not for everyone. I currently have Home Assistant running on a recycled OPC of mine, but it can run pretty well on something as small and lightweight as a Raspberry Pi as well. But don't expect everything to work out the box. You need to be ready to tinker. And you need to be ready to receive flack from your wife and family members too. That's it for today's video. Do let me know in the comments though if you think my home is smart.
Your smart home not smart!
Or if you agree with my partner and think it's not. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.